The put in plans to the borough council to build an actual jetty, which would make it easier for them to let the boats in and out and so forth. And they did that, and that's how the business sort of started. It just grew from that, as it were, over the years.
So you had your first jetty there by the Picky Pool?
Just right on the left-hand side of Picky Pool, as you're looking at it now. That's straight across the bay.
You've been several generations in this business now. Your name is synonymous with the whole of Bangor.
Well, I would say it is. Lairds boats are fairly well known in the province, as it were.
Why are you selling?
Well, with the new harbour development here in the marina and so forth, I have been made redundant, as it were.
Is there anyone to carry the business on? Another generation?
Oh, I wouldn't think so, no.
You didn't buy all your own boats, did you?
No, we built all our own boats.
Built them to your own design?
From my father's design, actually.
They're quite a distinctive boat, very low and sleek in the water.
Anybody in the boating business about Northern Ireland said you always knew a Laird boat looking at it because of the way it sat in the water.
What's this boat we're in now?
This here, all the boats that we run commercially were called Alice, mainly because my mother's name was Alice.
You must have known Bangor in its heyday.
Oh yes, Bangor was in its heyday for quite a few years, I would say. The 30s, the 40s and the 50s.
Is this when it became well known as a holiday resort?
Oh yes, it was very well known then. The type of people you got in Bangor were primarily Scotch people. They were about our number one tourists, Scotch people.
A lot of kilts about?
Oh yes, kilts and kilty bands and so forth, and plenty of noise, there's plenty of life about the place.
The business grew and expanded to include motorboats like this one here, like the Alice.
Oh, it did. By the time it come after the Second World War, whenever things were getting back to normal again, we kept expanding the business. And in our peak, which would have been in the 50s, I would say, we were up to a point where we were running 42 rowboats and 3 motorboats, and they were all doing fairly well, naturally.
So times change, things move on, and Bangor Bay has certainly changed a lot in recent years.
Oh, it has. It's no longer a bay in the sense of the words that people used to come down and sit in their cars and look out over Bangor Bay. Now they're looking out over a marina, which is quite nice, really. It's quite picturesque to see all the boats anchored in a spot where there was never boats anchored before.
I suppose you find it hard to keep up with these changes.
Well, you sort of have no option, and I couldn't very well stand in the way of progress.
Barry's amusements have gone, Caproni's ice cream, and now Lairds boats.
That's it. I sort of fell over backwards to not stand in the way of progress.
So with the changing face of Bangor Bay, I'm sure you find it hard to keep up with all these changes.
That's the end of another dynasty, as it were.
We're sitting in your last old boat.
This was Alice the 8th, actually, this particular boat we're in at the moment. All designed by my father.
Hand built by your father. I'm sure you're sad to see this last one go.
It sort of pulls at your heartstrings a wee bit. Knowing that you're never going to be helping some old lady to climb into the boat to go for a cruise around the bay or Carrickfergus or wherever it happened to be. In many ways it was a way of life as well as a business, you know. Especially for my father, I think it was his hobby as well as his business, which is a nice position to be in.